Hi, we're NSYNC, and we're on Loveline coming up next.
That's right. Next.
Loveline is meant for an adult audience. Loveline may contain sexually oriented content.
Loveline. Viewer discretion advised.
Hey, welcome to Loveline!
Chicks must really dig this blue shirt on me.
I think it's that bead of sweat.
All right, can we turn the air on? It's hot in here. No monitor, we got no air, this place is falling apart. Oh my God, I should have started a band. Look at these guys. 5 million records?
Yeah, working it, trying. All
right. And how did you guys get together?
Well, actually, I kind of started the group. Brought in a couple of my friends. I worked with him at Universal Studios, and these guys were on the Mickey Mouse Club. I don't know if you ever saw the new Mickey Mouse Club.
Right.
These guys were Mouseketeers.
What were you guys doing at Universal?
I was doing like 50s acapella stuff, and he was
singing,
a werewolf.
Singing and dancing.
Did you go out to Orlando too? For the gig, or had you relocated earlier?
Just relocated. He went to school, I went there with my family. Them two did the TV show 6 months out of the year.
We just kind of ran into each other.
And so why, why is everything going so well? I mean, there's a lot of bands that are talented bands that they bang around
it's
for 10 years.
It's your shirt.
It's like, we have the most incredible record company, RCA, and we have awesome management. The fans are incredible, and once they...
I know, but you gotta get the fans.
Now, the day I met these guys at the thing at Universal, there was about 80 celebrities all in a big bullpen, and all of a sudden you see this security train coming through, and everyone's like, who brought security? Like, everybody in the room did the same thing, and all of a sudden they're coming out, and he came up and said, oh, we love Loveline. As they're standing there, chicks are diving at them in the screen, just picking them up and moving them, and they just kept talking. Like, it's okay, they're just
I could never really evoke that response from a woman, but
nope.
My feeling is if you can get the first five to jump on you, the second five will just jump on you because the first five jumped on you.
Yeah.
Create a feeding frenzy. It's like some kind of, you know, sale at a bra store or something. You know, they start beating the crap out of each other.
I understand.
That's what I need. I need to hire the first five to jump on me so the rest just jump in.
This is your sort of MO with women. Hire. They're going to sing.
Really?
Yeah, that's what I hear.
We are?
Yeah, we are.
Okay. We can do that.
We can do that.
We do. Kind of get paid. Oh, okay. Want to sing something?
Yeah.
Okay. Ready? One, two, three.
Your love is like a river, peaceful and deep. Your soul is like a secret that I never could keep. When I look into your eyes, I know that it's true. God must have spent a little more time on you.
Bring on the question.
Wow.
Ready?
I was in a Rockefeller group in medical school.
Wow.
Should have kept going.
Drew was in an acapella group in
medical school.
The Rectal Pros?
The Medtones.
The Medtones? Oh, if I had just 30 seconds of footage of you idiots.
Oh, man.
Drew with some bad hair.
Yep.
All right, Casey. Oh, Wall of Shame. From the Wall of Shame. That's right. Yeah, any recordings of that? No. Casey?
Hi.
Hey.
I've been with my boyfriend for 2 years now, and he's always been really faithful to me, but he went on vacation to Mexico 2 weeks ago, and I went to pick him up at the airport, and his friend ran up to me and told me that he had performed oral sex on a Mexican stripper while
he was
there.
Wait a minute. His friend ran up to you at the airport?
No.
Yeah.
Hey, look what I...
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
You couldn't
wait.
Oh,
my gosh, girl, guess what he did?
All right.
So we haven't talked for 2 weeks, and I know I probably shouldn't, but I miss him because I really love him. I don't know what to do.
Oh, what did you confront him about it?
No, I won't return his phone calls.
Did you drive home from the airport without picking him up? Do we know that this actually happened?
Yeah, I left him there.
So you never even talked with him?
Pardon me?
You never even talked with him?
No.
Well, you were having a relationship with the guy. The friend must have had some M.O. to tell you this in such a heated way.
Well, because his friend was my friend, too.
I would give the boyfriend at least the opportunity to explain himself.
Give him the benefit of the doubt to say something.
Yeah. Hasn't he been calling you and all that?
Yeah, he was really drunk, but that's not really an excuse.
No, and Casey, it's good that you set up a big boundary. I think you just set it up a little early.
Yeah, I wonder if the friend is still alive.
Yeah.
Oh. Listen, this goes on at these bars. Called the Taste of Old Mexico. I was just supposed to have my face on a postcard. I don't know if you guys know this. Maybe it's been a long time.
I could have gone through life without knowing
Jesus,
it, too.
How old am I?
All right.
I'm telling you, in Tijuana, at least, this goes on. The guy's crawling up on their elbows in the middle of the state.
Stop with the imagery, all right? Stop. What we're telling her is to give the boyfriend an opportunity to express himself. You want to make contact. You want to preserve this relationship. He's made an egregious mistake, if indeed he did this. He wants to make amends. Give him some opportunity. This is not a long-standing pattern of this kind of behavior, is it?
No.
This is out of character.
How many Mexican hookers is he...
I would say
the last 6 months.
Give him at least an opportunity to make contact, explain himself, see how you feel about it, and maybe this is just one of those things that will pass and never happen again, we hope. Okay?
Okay, thanks.
All right. Hey, you could have honed his skills. You don't know.
Peace and order.
I'm just practicing, baby.
Oh, my God.
And what? He has such nice friends, the guy.
Oh.
You guys would have finished one record if you ratted each other out so badly.
Oh, and is stuffed in the Easy Bake Oven. That's just over Drew's left shoulder.
I'm never going to get over this.
And?
Okay, my question is this. I've been dating this guy for about 3 months now, and we had sex for the first time about a week ago. He had warned me about it, but it was the first time I had saw it. He has an overly enlarged testicle. It's about the size of a large apple, and to be honest with you, it really freaked me out and kind of turned me off. But I really like this guy, I just don't know what I should do about it. And also, I'm kind of worried about him because I don't know if it's some type of medical condition or what we can do about it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm worried too. It's great, look, it's understandable that it would kind of be unpleasant for you to look at that, but is it something he's had his whole life? Is it something that's grown rapidly recently? Has he ever had it looked at before?
I think he told me that something had happened to him. He had gotten hit there when he was younger.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That people can get hydroceles and spermatoceles and things like that after being socked there. But was it ever looked at?
Is that the testicle itself grown?
It's usually a cyst that grows off it.
Off the side of the testicle?
Yeah, but you can't tell that. It's just a large scrotum is all you see.
That's all I ever see. I mean, when I close my eyes, that's all I see, Drew. Your initials. So,
he needs to go to the doctor, but Anna, if you like the guy, I think you can probably get
over
it.
She'll get over it. But she's asking.
Yeah.
She knew what she was getting.
But you got to know, is this a new problem or not?
I think he has had it looked at, and I think they maybe are doing something about it. I don't know. I'm not really that clear right now.
Then leave it alone, because you know what? At some point in your life, maybe one breast is going to grow bigger than the other, and it's really not a big deal.
If you really like the guy, you know, physical things shouldn't have anything to do with it.
Especially when nobody else needs them but you. It's not like he's in the bar with the growth on the side of his head.
The guy can even walk straight, right? He doesn't pull to one side or anything, right?
Yeah.
He's all right. It really fills out the trunks, right, at the beach?
Definitely.
I'll tell you, I would not mind an enlarged testy. I mean, for certain applications, like poolside, you adjust yourself just right, you put it, you know, where the penis would have been, and...
You look good.
Yeah.
Where the penis is supposed to be.
Thank you, girl.
Boy, that man.
Wow. Yeah, Drew went down, one time he sat me down and drew me a picture of where my penis was supposed to be. All right, Ann, don't give the guy any more syrus than he's already gotten.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Your concern is well placed. It's okay to be kind of uncomfortable looking at it. You'll get used to it if you really care about this guy. Thank you, Ann.
Thank you.
And if this scrotum is not a particularly aesthetically pleasing area anyway.
I'm not clear that it can be made worse.
Yeah, it's like a turkey or something. Oh, that one's really handsome. Let's not eat it. This one's butt ugly. No, they're all ugly. Every scrotum is ugly. It's degree, but they're all ugly, right, Drew?
These guys aren't.
You guys got, well, these guys have handsome scrotum.
All right, Michelle at the Wall of Shame.
They don't listen to you, Drew.
Michelle.
I recently broke up with my boyfriend of 2 years, and he was really devastated, but he's coming down to visit me in about a week, and I don't want to get back together with him. I don't want a relationship. So how do I tell him that I want him to be my sex buddy?
Hang on a second. I'm a little confused.
What was
that last part?
He's coming.
It was cool up until the end.
Yeah.
He's coming to Hawaii to visit you?
No. I'm school here in L.A., and he's coming down to visit me.
He lives in California somewhere.
Yeah.
Why are you letting him come down and visit you if you don't want the relationship?
No, she wants to be sex buddies.
Is he aware that this is how it's going down?
Not totally. Like, we've had a sexual relationship for a long time, and I'm kind of...
Is he, like, attached, or is he kind of down with it the same way you are?
No, I don't think so. He's pretty attached, and I think he's kind of maybe going to try and use it against me, because he knows that that's what I'm going to want. But he wants to get back together, and so it's
this is only going to hurt him even more.
How old is he?
If you have sex with him.
He's 18.
18.
He's going to get sucked in.
This is the reversal of the usual situation where the women are being used in this fashion. And
there's this sort of myth that guys are impervious to this kind of pain, especially if they're getting some. But there are guys out there.
Especially at that age.
At 18, who are in love, and this is only going to sort of twist the knife.
In fact, it is particularly the kind of guys that get sucked into these sort of enmeshed relationships that stay with this kind of thing and get preoccupied about it and suffer. You want to be clear with this guy. I mean, you're being unfair to him.
Right, and you probably are setting yourself up for an immense amount of trouble.
Hassle,
luggage, phone calls, insanity. Just if you really just want to have sex with someone with no baggage. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's unfair to him.
Okay.
It really is. You're
going
to be
back to Hawaii, find one of those guys with the big calves.
Scott?
Yeah. Oh, okay, about a month ago, I ran into an ex-girlfriend that I dated 6 years ago. And her friends came over and told me to go talk to her. And so we went and talked, and she said she was having trouble with her marriage. And so we talked some more. I slow danced with her a couple times. And I ended up taking her home, and I slept with her. And then I've talked to her ever since that day, and I've slept with her for about 10 times. Now, I really love her, but the whole thing makes me nervous, and I don't know if I should give her an ultimatum about no sex, because the divorce is final or what.
All right. Good dilemma. Scott's the kind of guy who has some conscience, but not much.
For this show.
It's a train load for this show. All right, we're going to take ourselves a break. We'll take a look at NSYNC video during the break. Drew will go out in the audience after the break, and we'll all be back. Your soul is like a secret that I never could keep. When I look into your eyes, I know that it's true. God must have spent a little more time.
Bye.
band with Justin, Joey, Chris, JC, and Lance, all of them in sync. Drew, out in the audience.
Out of sync.
That wasn't for you.
Oh, I know.
You know that, right? I don't want you for a second to think that applause is for you.
Believe me, I understand.
Okay. Scott is on the phone. He has an ex-girlfriend. He got back with her. Her marriage isn't going well. She's turned to him. They're having sex. He doesn't feel good about it. She says she's getting divorced. Is she getting divorced?
Yeah, she said that she wants a divorce.
Yeah, but is she separated now? Are they still living together?
No, she kicked him out of the house about last week.
Uh-huh. Hey, are there kids involved?
No, no kids.
All right.
Let's hear what the audience
says. There's a huge part about how persuaded Scott was. Her friends came and told you to go talk to her, and you had a couple of things. It sounds like you're getting pulled around.
No, but this is somebody you used to date, and he was into a lot, too, right?
Well, I was really nervous about talking to her because we left on bad terms.
But you were into her at one time.
Oh, yes. I dated her for 2 years.
See. Hold on a sec. Here's the audience input.
I just feel that he needs to kind of get out of the situation because the woman really doesn't know what she wants, and therefore she needs to work out all of her problems with her marriage, her divorce, whatever's going to happen before someone else decides to jump into the situation and make it even worse.
So clarify. Yeah. Clarify what's going on.
I feel like she made a vow, so what makes you think everything's going to work out the way you want it to? Like, she needs to deal with her own problems first before she even starts running to anybody else.
You mean you think she'll do the same thing to him?
Yeah. I mean, she's married. She made a vow. She made a promise to somebody. So therefore, you would want to do your all to make that work.
Or leave it if it's done. You don't need to break your vow to get out of it.
I want to know, does this guy know that she is seeing this guy now?
She's hiding it from him.
She is. Now, were you seeing her? Were you seeing her before she was separated or after?
Right before.
Does he own a gun?
See, I mean, if she deceived the guy she made her vows to, so to speak, you know, I mean, that I think that's an example for you to see that she's probably not right for you.
Well, I consider that as well, but I think it's a lot different.
It's not a lot different.
It's not different
well,
at all.
But we don't know what her husband's up to. He may be
a world-class a-hole. Yeah. But then again, she found a world-class a-hole and decided to marry.
And it's why it's that part of her that's keeping her kind of in and out of that relationship. It's like the married male who keeps saying he's going to leave his wife. Whoever's involved with a married person, stand back, stop, allow that couple to resolve what it is they're going to do, either commit to one another or end the marriage. When it is truly over, then it's fine to step in and have a relationship. Until that's clarified, you're asking for a world of hurt, so don't do it.
And if he wasn't so desperate, he's desperate.
Yeah.
And he's picking up the scraps.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Because it's going to be a nightmare relationship.
Just go out and start new.
Anyway.
Get rid of all the baggage. Find something. And by the way, don't everyone be surprised when people who are in the midst of screwing someone over screw you over eventually,
That's
too.
Right. That's
when
right.
you buy a box from some guy in a van in the parking lot who says he just ripped it off from a stereo store, don't be shocked when there's a brick in there.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You gotta be careful too that like she's not having problems with him and using him as kind
of
like
it's all part of the chaos. It's all part of the chaos.
Start new.
Yeah, let her figure out what she's gonna do. Do it, and then you can have a relationship if she's still available. Eileen in the Easy Bake Oven. Whoop.
Drew, you're really taking care of business tonight.
Am I? That's kind of out of it last night, wasn't it?
Yeah, Drew's compensating.
Yeah.
I told him I'm tired of towing the line. Step up.
So I actually thanked him for doing such a good job, and he started abusing me. Eileen, what's going on?
You're damn straight.
Hi, last week my boyfriend and I were having sex and he put his index finger in my butt while having sex. Now this is bend me over sex, not regular sex, kind of like, and I told him to stop because I didn't like it, and I asked him why he did that, and I guess he gets off on it. Now I would like to know, is that normal or is he just weird?
Funny, she was able to distinguish. She knew what finger it was.
In the index finger.
I had my girl once yell to get my pinky out of her. I had to explain to her. It
wasn't your hand.
It wasn't the hand, no.
I think when most people do this, he's not doing that for his pleasure. He's doing that for what he believes is your pleasure. And if you don't like it, you don't like it. He's not from another planet. That comes up all the time on the show.
But it's a sort of his pleasure, your pleasure thing. The lines get crossed because some people's pleasure is giving other people's pleasure. Well,
and also other people, men particularly, tend to do what they think, what they would like done to them.
To them.
They think
right, but his index finger isn't any happier for this. It's not he's getting something out of this.
All right, so what we're saying is it's not way outside of the spectrum of normal behavior. She shouldn't be worried that it means something about him. The only thing you got to be concerned with is whether he listens to you when you tell him what you do and do not like. If he's listening, if he responds, then no problem, okay?
Okay.
All right. All right. He hasn't... make sure he wasn't with any championship teams, you know, those big gaudy
Super Bowl
or national championship rings.
Do you wear those on the index finger, though?
Okay.
Simon.
About 2 weeks ago, I went out to a strip club and I got my first lap dance. The dancer was pretty fly, so I asked her out and we went out about 6 times. And she thinks it's sweet that we haven't had sex, but the truth is I can't get out of my head that she touches and gets other men horny for a little. I wonder about her slutty behavior. I think I'll lose her if I ask her about sex. What should I do?
You'll lose her if what?
If I asked her about how many times she has sex.
I mean, is she with multiple partners, is your question?
Yeah.
Yeah, but if you feel uncomfortable with the fact that the girl takes her clothes off and touches other men, that's what she does.
It really doesn't matter
how many people she slept with. That's her job, and if you don't like that, probably a good instinct. Stick with it.
Yeah, but I'm uncomfortable with that. But then, on the other hand, she's a great person, you know what I'm saying? She's a beautiful person and a beautiful woman.
Wait, Simon. Wait a minute.
You know
a great person? Translate that, please.
Are you real serious?
Wait. I want Adam's translation on this guy.
In what language?
In Malese.
She's really hot, and I'd be really cool in front of my friends if I was dating a stripper.
she's good looking and hasn't tried to kill me.
My friends don't know about this, though. You know what I'm saying? It's like low profile.
Wait. Adam's been through this experience. How did you... No, yeah.
The Tijuana one?
No, the one up here.
Stateside?
The one up here.
Just the American version. That's all they've been on
TV. Yeah, I dated a stripper for a while. His name was Duke. Catlin was her stripper name. And, you know, just a topless place. You know, she was nice working her way through college.
Well, I tried
to get her out of it. Because we were living together for a while, too. And I didn't like her going off and doing this. You know, it's typical male crap. And, you know, she resented me because... I got her out, you know, 2 years before she was ready to get out, and she then got a job as a receptionist, and after taxes, and a full week, and packing, brown bagging it, she was making like $285 a week take home. A serious, you know, 9-hour day. She was making $250, $300 in a 4-hour shift, spending the day at the beach, you know, just one day when she was working at the bar. So she was pissed. And I wasn't exactly bringing home the bacon either. So she resented me.
All right, regardless of whether
money. So she's going to resent
you. Money is one issue that women have trouble sort of disconnecting from. It's a very addictive, compelling, compulsive world to be in. But also, she needs that. There's a reason women do that.
And for Simon and for anyone else, when you meet someone, you can't go in and look at the package and then get the package and decide you don't want it. Now you're going to rewrap it.
Right.
If that's what she does, that's what she does.
It's true.
You
just
take
in
her
general in
that.
Relationships. I mean, except it's about dealing with people as who they really are. And if you don't like who they are,
don't do it.
So, okay.
All right, Simon?
Yeah.
So we put a little hole.
I'm telling you, it's all right.
You know, it sucks when they rerun these shows, which has happened to me once. They've reran the show. I've been sitting around on a Friday night in front of the TV with the girlfriend, the current girlfriend, waxing on about the stripper. Oh, best sex I ever had!
Oh, boy.
That's trouble.
Boy.
Oh, that is serious trouble.
Your girlfriend's got to be sainted.
She's got to be institutionalized.
Yeah,
while she's strapped down. All right, Pam is on the phone.
Hi. My step-grandfather touched my breast and tried to kiss me. I did confront him about this, but it became really ugly, and he fell to the floor. Now, whenever I fantasize or try to have sex, the breast he touched becomes warm, and I have... I keep thinking about what he did to me.
Wow. And he fell to the floor because you hit him with this news? Because old people fall down all the time.
What happened?
He clutched, like, his heart and went down to the floor?
Oh, I wish. I wish.
All right.
But my boyfriend is becoming really angry because I don't want to have sex as much anymore. How can I get my step-grandfather out of my head while I'm having sex?
All right. This is good. I would stick around for this one, even if my girlfriend is pissed and we're watching the show. All right. Pam, we're going to get to this. We'll take a look at a little more from the NSYNC video, and then we'll come back.
Brother loved the other sister, but then she fell in love with the drummer. Oh, brother. This boy loved that boy, even though that boy said he loves girls. Huh.
Isaac, you'll be watching Loveline on MTV.
You can email your questions at loveline3@AOL.com. Please include your phone number.
Where the hell were we? NSYNC is here.
They really do need to tell us when the cameras are going on, don't they?
I saw them. I just figured, I like to wait a couple of seconds. Makes the show feel organic. Yeah. Drew and I cuddling during the break. Pam is still on the phone. Pam's step-grandfather copped a feel when she was how old?
This was just last year.
Oh!
Right. Six.
I thought she was talking about as a kid.
Yeah. No.
And you at that moment when it happened, you confronted him?
No, it was the next day that I confronted
him. Is he demented or is he ill in any way? I mean, is it just sort of erratic behavior of a very old man? Was this volitional, intentional behavior? Or is this somebody like a severe dementia that just,
he actually maneuvered this. He made a point to come around and put his arm on my shoulder.
Okay.
And
all right. And is it?
But he didn't. There was no small talk. No lunch.
No dinner. No movie.
No making
nothing.
Out. Just went right for the boob.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, my feeling is like the guy's going, hey, 80. I'm 85. F it. I don't got time for that. Boy, your eyes are blue. Crap. I'm going right for the boob.
How long has he been your step grandfather?
Since I was 7.
Is this the first time anything like this has happened to you?
Or yeah.
Just nothing in your life.
Okay, well, let me say this. Drew, and Pam and everybody, this is a form of some dementia. I mean, it may not be full-blown. He doesn't know where he is.
Impulse control problem.
But to walk up to someone you've known for 20 years who's in the family and just grab for the boob, something's up.
An average of 40, 50 years difference on you, and everyone in your family may know.
And Pam, I think if you really look at what's going on with your grandfather, I bet he has a beginning of a dementia. This is what people with dementias do, that they often become sexually very inappropriate.
I'm sorry. The problem is I found out that he did this to an aunt of mine.
When?
15 years ago.
Ooh.
Right. Yeah. Not long after he married my grandmother.
How has he been otherwise? I mean, as a grandfather. Is he a
weirdo? He lives in a different state, so I didn't see him all that often. But he was the typical nice guy out pottering in the garden, that sort of crap.
So when he's not planting bombs, he's raping. But other than the attempted rape, he's pretty straightforward.
And did you tell your parents?
I told my mother, yeah.
That his stepfather, her stepfather?
Yeah, yeah.
How did she react?
She was not well pleased. She was highly incensed.
But let me explore a little bit with you. Oftentimes, family members are not aware when an older person is developing a dementia. It's usually very slow and insidious, and people aren't used to looking for the signs. And when you're in a family system, you kind of have a certain amount of denial about what's going on. So, I mean, has he done anything inappropriate, ever gotten lost? Is his personality changing? Does he say weird things once in a while? Anything like that happening?
Not as far as I can find out.
Okay. Well, let's just move on. Forget about him and say, why are you so traumatized by this?
You're 26 years old. 26
years old.
Happened to you.
You know, grandpa tries to cop something. Yeah, so he's an idiot.
Do you understand what he's saying, Pam? At 26 years old, you defended yourself. You took care of yourself. You left the situation. You're capable of taking care of yourself in the future. You confronted it. It doesn't seem like something that would stay this heavy on your heart for a year.
Well, he was someone I looked up to. He was the main male in my life.
He was? He doesn't sound like it. I mean, you haven't talked to him much. He lives out of state.
You barely knew him.
You barely know him.
You don't know if he's been behaving strangely.
What do you mean the main male you looked up to?
Well, my father died when I was a year old, and so I sort of idolized my step-grandfather.
That you didn't know that you first came into your life at 7?
Right.
So you idolized him from afar?
Right.
So he's not the person that you made him out to be. What does that have to do with you not being able to have sex? Like, the man poses no threat to you, and from the way you handled the situation, there's no other threat. You handled it. You survived.
Pam,
nothing happened.
Something else happened to you, and look into it. And we don't have enough time, but something else is going on in your life.
And maybe it is, again, lots of other possibilities here. Maybe she's depressed. Maybe this is re-triggering old issues of grief and loss in relation to her dad, but it is not about what you're having symptoms around right now. There's something more global going on here. We can't quite get to it, but it's an exaggerated reaction to an unfortunate situation that you handled very well. But talk
Look
about
at
your
what
feelings.
Else is in your life.
Talk with your boyfriend. It sounds like he's being fairly patient with this, really.
Mm-hmm.
But talk about your feelings. Try to figure it out. And if you can't, you might want to get some
professional help.
Let
this be a lesson to all of yous out there. Whenever someone seems like they're spinning out or making too big a deal out of whatever it is, whether it's the chick in front of you in the supermarket who's brought to tears because the guy's doing a price check, you know, whatever's going on, or the guy who's, you know, cut you off of the freeway and he's waving a gun around now, there's a whole lot more than whatever it is, whatever the incident was going on.
Absolutely.
And we're all hearing it here in Pam's case.
Yeah.
We're all thinking, just get over it, and she's ready to check herself in.
Right.
Yeah. So there's something else going on. Examine that and stop focusing on Grandpa and his old hand with the veins in it.
Crystal. Crystal's on the phone.
Hi. I've been with my boyfriend for about 3 months. And the other day, I was pulling out his pants to give him oral sex, and I realized that he had an uncircumcised penis. I learned in sex ed class that uncircumcised penises like his carry lots of diseases.
Oh, my God.
Like his, especially.
Sometimes it can be a family of possums.
Hey, I want to have sex with him, but I've been avoiding penis because I'm scared of it. What should I do?
What diseases are they supposed to...
I don't know. I learned
malaria, typhoid,
schistosomiasis.
You weren't paying attention in class, honey.
Uh-huh. No, I learned in sex ed class that the foreskin impacts it.
The what?
Okay, so what were the diseases?
Like certain STDs. I don't know what type. They didn't say, but they said that they carry lots of diseases.
Hold on, you're 23?
Yes, ma'am, sir.
You're in school.
You're in school.
I was crap on my shoe.
So let's deal with the issue at hand.
All right.
Yes.
I mean, I know that condoms will help me, but I'm allergic to condoms.
Right.
You can use a polyurethane condom, okay? You wouldn't be allergic to that.
Okay.
That indeed there are bacteria and fungus that can grow under the foreskin, but if somebody's maintaining proper hygiene, it shouldn't be an issue, and it shouldn't be something transmissible to you.
Doesn't
increase the risk of other sexually transmitted diseases. What?
Which means if you're not a doctor, if the guy showers, you're fine.
Point is if you had a kid, if we had a child today,
yes.
That by the time the guy got into junior high where they could make fun of his penis, probably 50% or 60% of his peers
would
be uncircumcised.
Because I don't know anyone that's doing it anymore.
Right.
None of my peers.
I was just saying it is going on, but it's not what it was.
It's still thought of as all things being equal, a healthier thing to do. All things being equal.
All right.
But not necessary.
Dave is 22 and on the phone. Dave?
Hi.
Hey.
I am. I've always masturbated, but I started getting acne when I was around 19. And I'm a good-looking guy, but the acne changed my looks. I went to an alternative medicine doctor in South America, and he told me that the acne was caused by the masturbation.
Oh.
I couldn't stop, so I still have the acne. Is this true?
What?
If I stop, will it go away?
You'll go blind.
Yeah. Totally.
All right.
alternative medicine doctor in South America.
My feeling is people that go to non-professional
or paraprofessional. That's like the guy with the brick in his box.
Yeah, right. It's more of that because people hold their great esteem, people in the paraprofessional world. Just enjoy. You get what you ask for when you go to
a good lunch. All right, well, we got to take a break.
Yeah.
And when we come back, we'll make fun of Dave. And possibly his family, because I think they had a party. Justin, Joey, Chris, JC, and Lance from the NSYNC group there.
With gifts girls, from the audience.
Girls seem to appreciate that. Yeah, done the show for three
Check
years,
this.
Didn't get anything.
Those Nike socks?
And I got a venereal disease from one of the kids once. Got the cramps
is it
one
your
time.
Birthday?
Actually, this month it is. Well,
wow.
It just actually passed, if anything. January 28th is my birthday.
Wow.
Well, give him a hand for his birthday.
Hey. Come on.
Dave's on the phone.
Dave was a good-looking guy.
With acne.
Yeah.
That he
went,
blames.
Went to some South American witch doctor to get it cured. Seems like a lot of trouble. There must be some story behind that. Is your family from that area?
Exactly. Yeah. But see, I always masturbated, but the acne didn't come in until I was like 19.
Dave, the acne, there's no relationship between those two things.
Let me tell you what happened.
Did you masturbate before?
I think your mom called the
staff. That's exactly what happened. This is what I'm going to do with my kids, too. I'm going to take you to the family doctor. Yeah, but this guy will not be a doctor.
With lots of ceremony.
Have the thing on. Yeah, and then if we peel off a couple 20s, okay, you know, whatever it is. I think he's wanking off. And then whatever it is, that's what he's going to tell him not to do.
Right. No relationship. Acne is caused. Nobody knows for sure what causes acne. It's a complex issue. It has to do with bacteria.
My face would look like a beet.
Does it? That's
it
right.
Would.
You would be. You'd explode.
There'd be one big whitehead.
That's right. But there's all sorts of people have grappled with whether or not it has to do with hormone levels or diet or stress. Yeah, some of these things may factor in a little bit, but for crying out loud, Dave, acne is a completely treatable condition today. Between the topical agents and antibiotics and Accutane and I mean, you shouldn't have acne in 1999. It's just completely treatable. Go see a dermatologist and have it treated, okay?
Okay.
All right. Bye-bye.
All right. You guys can't afford to get a zit. All right?
Yeah. Hey, I've never been on
Come
any
on
of Accutane or anything.
Oh, you guys are lucky, too, because you're in zit country. I mean, age-wise.
Yeah.
I don't know, when is the time you're in the zit zone?
It's like
13 I don't think it would matter.
The lucky part about TV is we wear all the makeup and stuff.
Let me tell you something, all you youngins who think you're not going to get a zit, you know, after like 21, 22, you will. Believe me. I got a gray hair on my ass and a zit.
You too?
Yeah, it's like, what is this? Too old for that, Drew.
Yes, indeed.
All right. Hey, we got the books. Well, hold the book up there, Drew. That's our book. We're trying to make a little scratch, too.
Yeah.
Now, we're going to give you guys a book, but I think we should only give it to them if they sing a little something else. I don't know if you're...
All right. Listen, I want a book so bad.
This song is from our self-titled album, which is in stores now.
It's called Zit Country.
And you can check out our book, our official.
We've had practice. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I lie awake. I drive myself crazy. Drive myself crazy. Thinking of you, made a mistake when I let you go, baby.
I drive myself crazy,
wanting you the way that I do,
wanting you the way that I do.
Oh yeah.
There's actually something in her about acne.
My prediction is the books, the teddy bears, none of it makes it out of the limo.
That's just my prediction.
All right. Will.
All right, NSYNC, everybody. Give them a hand. Home for Christmas is the name of the Christmas CD. You may want to grab that while you're picking up your second or third NSYNC CD. And until next time, this is Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew and Diane Farr saying mahalo.